Hey, everyone, what's going on? How are you guys? Week going? My week is going awesome. Last night I went to the casino in Flamberg. It was awesome. I think I am allowed to tell people that on YouTube. So I am right now balancing two videos. This one and my all massive speckle really amazing 100th video that I am doing to do next week, a week from tonight. I am so super excited to do it. At the end of this video, I am going to tell you all about it. It will be probably the best video I ever did. Even better than my highest viewed video that I did back in March of 2 years ago last year in 2021. Summary, my mind is already switched over to 2023, because we are exiting 9 days, 4 minutes, 14 minutes, and 21 seconds away from January 1st, 2023. Wow, and we're just only 2 days, 3 hours, 11 minutes, and 22 seconds away from Christmas, which is really exciting. As some of you guys know that 3 days after I got the Samsung Galaxy F53 phone, I thought at first, oh cool, score, get a brand new phone. But then after 3 days my smile turned upside down after I looked at the specs online at GSM Arena. I'll leave the link down in the description of this video. So make sure to check it out if you want or wish. GSM Arena has got everything, phone specs, and even rumors, and wow, it's awesome. It even has got the specs already of the brand new 2 months away from the release of Samsung Galaxy S23 lineup of phones, and hopefully Samsung doesn't make the Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus have a even less than a 4,500 mAh battery. Like what they did the Samsung Galaxy S22 Plus model that came out this year, which for some reason has got a smaller screen by 0.1 inches and a 300 mAh less battery cell on it than the Samsung S21 had got a 4,800 mAh battery cell in it and 6.7 inch screen size rather than the S22 Plus. There is quite a lot of rumors about the Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus floating around online. I will save it until I do my really special 100th video that will be next week. You guys don't want to miss that video. I decided to buy the Samsung Galaxy S73, which is basically the same exact phone as the F53, except it has got a 6.7 inch screen size with a 120 Hz refresh rate, rather than 6.4 inch screen size with only a 60 Hz refresh rate, which I found out that 120 Hz display is smoother and doesn't lag at all than 60 Hz refresh rate found on mine with kind of smooth, but sometime it lags when I scroll up and down on Facebook or on my email or something. The point is, I understand what's the difference between a 60 Hz refresh rate and a 120 Hz rate, which 120 Hz is also on my dad's Samsung Galaxy S21 Plus. I was mad at myself last week on Monday night. I was ready to buy it but then decided not to. I should have thought it was stupid. See, I didn't want to spend $1,200 for a phone that I am only going to use for a year and then be done with it. So anyways, the Samsung Galaxy S73 one that I bought plus tax came to being almost $700, just say under that amount. I looked at the specs online on that GSM Arena website that I mentioned earlier. The specs for it, if camera is just like my broken Motorola, got a 109 millipixel wide camera lens on it. But other than that, except for the screen, which I am used a 6.7-inch screen, it's garbage. I am sorry, this phone is 2.5 years old and it has got wireless charging, which is a really cool feature to have. I don't want that phone, and I asked if it can be cancelled, but it was too late already on its way from Best Buy. You got a few ideas. One is wrap it up and give it to my family for a Christmas gift. In life, sometimes I just have to deal with whatever phone I get or get handed to me, which I want the best of the best. I tried 3 or so weeks ago to offer my dad $500 for it, because online on eBay or Kijiji people are selling them for anywhere from $400 to $600 for a used model of Samsung Galaxy S21 Plus that costs that much. It has got a small crack in the top left-hand corner of his screen, so when it's only 128GB model with no removable storage, maybe after saying that I think that 500 might be a bit high for it, 475 final offer like Shark Tank and Pawn Stars. I see the value in things like mine only get highest price $150 for it.
Yeah, but again,
So anyways, I am going to decide on Sunday, which is Christmas Day, whether or not I am going with either my iPhone SE 2, which only have got support and software updates for about 4 more months until April 17th of 2023, or get my dad's Samsung Galaxy S21. Plus, or if I have to go back to iPhone to fix my Apple Watch, then I will find a cheap iPhone 8 Plus, which is the last iPhone to have support, and getting software updates that I will find and buy it online somewhere. The only real reason that in February I switched over to the Android world, which is because of my dad gave me one of his old Motorola's, even though I am a diehard Apple fan, and will buy iPhone again someday. Again, I don't like the notch at the top of the past 5 years of the eyesore notch of the screen. It's an eyesore. I don't mind the pinhole at the top of Android phones nowadays. So, and because of that nice and big and beautiful 6.7-inch display, I want to go into the new year 2023 with a phone that has got a nice big screen like my Motorola had, a 5,000 milliamp battery cell in it, 120 hertz refresh rate, wireless charging support, Corning Gorilla Glass Vitis, which apparently is the strongest glass on a smartphone right now. Touch ID sensor on the front or under the display. I don't care if it's ultrasonic reader or not. My old Motorola from 2020 didn't have an ultrasonic fingerprint reader, and I couldn't tell the difference without it. A physical home button preferred, but nowadays you can't really find a smartphone with a physical home button. If no microSD card, then preferably either 256GB or 512GB, but 128GB only if comes with removable storage for microSD card. 4K camera system is fine, I guess. I am not a big picture kind of guy. 64 megapixel camera lens system is fine. At least 6GB of RAM. I am not a big time gamer, so 6 is fine. 4 on this is not enough. My iPhone SE 2 has got 6GB. My old Motorola had 12GB of RAM. This Samsung I got now is triple less. The new Motorola X40 phone, which hits stores like Best Buy and Rogers tomorrow. Sadly, I can't go because it's my final day of school for my second year of college of 2022. Then I am off until January 9th. I can't believe that this year I will get a week off before New Year's and a week after wow crazy. The same thing happened to me for my first year of college online last year in 2021, even though I didn't get a week off in the new year started 2022. I was back on starting Monday, January 3rd, but this time I get a whole week off in the new year until the 9th, which is sweet and really awesome. Hopefully get to see that new Megan movie in theaters on the 5th. I really want to go see that movie. It's already out in Los Angeles. So that movie looks so good. I love those kinds of movies. It's a drama, and it's a horror movie. There I came out and said it. Thoughts are real me. I love horror movies. I have got about 12 of those kinds of movies saved on my dad's PVR. I am sharing it with him because it's kind of a long story. I used to have one for about 2 years, but it was in my room and I couldn't sleep at night. It was awful for about 17 months, and finally I wanted to move the TV by myself out of my room, but it was sitting on this coffee cabinet about 3 feet high, and I tried to move the whole cabinet with the TV sitting on it so I can remove the wires from the back of the TV, so anyhow it somehow fell and it seemed fine. I mean, it looked fine when I pick it up from the floor, but when I tuned the TV on, there were lines through it, and I said, "Papa, dang it, all, I don't like to dance." I dance with my hands like Jesus said. Sorry, I was thinking of that song from the number one hit show on Netflix called Wednesday. It's a pretty great show. It's with Jenna Organ, and it which she will be in that horror Megan movie. I realized that I have been pleasing people like my family of who I really am as a person, and I always been afraid of people judge me for doing something, or watching horror movies or something not likable that my family like. I have to stand up for who I really am, and yes, I am a Christian, but I don't go to church anymore, but I really like watching Andrew Farley. I am kind of weird in that way. I like to watch Andrew Farley and likes to watch In Touch on Sunday mornings, but I really like watching horror movies. Every year I do a wrap-up of the year-end, and I have been working on my really special 10th year of doing them. So I recap the top 25 movies, video games, songs, delves, and talk about my point of view about how was the year that we all had and what I am looking forward to next year. So now on to quickly talking about the main topic of this video, which is all about the first ever smartwatch ever made and created by Google. Sadly, I don't have got a photo of it because I am at my dad's house, and for 2 years for some reason my printer working, but when I print it's coming out blank, which makes no sense. So for one of my Christmas gifts, fix my printer so I can print off stuff. Thoughts, why I have been using all of my mom's paper and ink. So thoughts why, anyhow, on to talking all about Google Pixel Watch, first general ever made by Google. Finally, Google made their very own smartwatch. So let's start. The Google Pixel Watch 1 is a Wear OS smartwatch designed, developed, and manufactured by Google as part of their Pixel product lineup that is first previewed in May 2022 during the Google keynote. I better save this into my calendar for next year. So I know when is the Google keynote because I might consider just using my iPhone SE 2 until April and then go buy the iPhone SE 3 that came out this year in April because I didn't want to steal my dad's Motorola phone to begin with. I was just totally fine with my iPhone SE 2 that I got back in September of 2020. It was all according to plan until I got jealous of my dad and used and stole his Motorola. And now I want to be done with this whole jealously and stick with my iPhone SE 2, which I really love and adore because it's got wireless charging capabilities on it and it has got the best speakers in the world. Apple really did a great job on making the iPhone SE 2, also known as iPhone SE 2020. I thought that my first ever iPhone I ever got when I was about 16 or 17 was iPhone SE 1 from 2016, but then I found out it was iPhone 5S from 2013. Next year in September, when the phone turns 10 years old, going to make a special video all about it. I am thinking because I somehow locked it with a passcode and put voiceover on by mistake. I want to show you guys what stuff is on it and which version of iOS it's running and can support up to. So I decided that I just going to buy a really cheap one from eBay or Kijiji or Amazon just to show you my very first iPhone that I ever got when I was just 16 years old. I bought it actually from the corner store near my high school, good old St. Mary's in Canada, Ontario. So I am really excited for sharing that video with you guys here on my YouTube channel. Anyhow, moving on. Back talking about Google's first ever Pixel Watch, which I am going to do a pretend unboxing for you guys to see the watch itself. So it features a dome-shaped display as well as heavy integration with Fitbit, which Google acquired back in 2021. The idea of a Pixel smartwatch by Google was created back in July of 2016, so I don't know why it was planned but cancelled because of hardware and chief Rico Sterling didn't fit well at the time when the Pixel 1 by Google came out back in 2016. Development on a new Pixel branded watch began shortly after Google's acquisition of Fitbit. It was first released about 2 months ago when the new Google Pixel 7 and 7 Pro were released on October 13th. Sorry, so I am going to use my iPhone SE 3 for about half a year or 5 months as my main cell phone until the Google Pixel 8 Pro comes out, which I thinking someday in the middle of October 2023. And I am going to use my So you need to go to the Google Play Store on your phone and download the Google Pixel Watch app. 2 years ago I had TT do it on my iPhone. Wow, just 4 steps to set up your watch. That was easy and fast, wow. Good job, Google. Wow, really cool, you get 6 months of Fitbit Plus, which is like Apple Fitness Plus. I never bought that, don't need to. Wow, kind of nice, someone in my family would be getting 6 months free of Fitbit Plus, and then if you want to continue, it comes with a cost and a price. I don't know, it starts when you first get it or you first set it up, because it's a Christmas gift for someone in my family, which goes great with their new Google Pixel 7 Pro. You can either set up your watch with a four-die Puscoder pattern. I use the Puscode on my Apple Watch. Just some setup to be done on your watch, and it's totally the same exact setup as my Apple Watch that I set up 2 days ago. You can choose between different watch faces, same as my Apple Watch, nothing different there. I always have got always on display turned on, it's basically the exact. My overall point of view coming from watching someone unbox this and set it up, I mean, it's a really nice watch, but some people online said it's overpriced, and I would definitely agree. The Apple Watch has got a 1.9-inch square screen with a 120Hz refresh rate, while the new Google Pixel Watch Series 1 has got a 1.5-inch rounded watch with only a 90Hz refresh rate. I am not surprised with this because it's only the first general of its kind. Google over the years will make their Google Pixel Watch better. Next year, Google will come out with their Google Pixel Watch Series 2 alongside their Pixel 8 and 8 Pro, which there's already been some rumors. Actually, the Google Watch looks exactly the same as a Samsung Galaxy Watch. So thoughts my video, so if you all enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and I want to wish everyone a happy and wonderful Merry Christmas. There's apparently a big snowstorm headed from the US to Canada this weekend starting tomorrow. So thanks for watching, and I see you all next week for my Speckle 100th big massive video, and here's a sneak peek of what my video holds and got in store right after this Christmas song, and this song is my second all-time favorite Christmas song.
In the sunset, I sweep the snow from my doorstep. I just can't help but stop and grin. It's like I'm 10 years old again. And everywhere I go, I can feel it. Some say it moves like a spirit. It falls on us once a year, like it came on a midnight clear. So love, this season is a gift. When love came down to this list, let's open up and let our hearts embrace this moment.
Don't miss from the Orgamil Accessibility Guy. On Thursday, December 29th at 9, he's doing not only his New Year's Eve video, and bring in 2023, and saying goodbye to 2022. He hit his milestone 100th special video. His very special 100th video will have some dancing. The reason he started YouTube, his shortest and longest, most and least dot viewed video, a recap of what happened and what all, another great and awesome year we all had, what was the top move, a song and video game of the year. Number 1 smartphone of 2022. first and last phones to come out in 2022. A special dance that he'd been practicing. Upcoming and looking forward to 2023. The Accessibility Guy second custom mashup mix of songs from 2022. Number one song of 2022. Countdown to ring in 2023 and future videos from the Accessibility Guy. You don't want to miss it in a very special appearance from this dog copper. This video will be a video like no other. By the way, before I end this video off, don't miss on Saturday, December 24th from noon to 3. It's the top 30 songs of 2022 on 103.5 Up Canada in Bancroft, Ontario, Canada. And at the same time from 11:30 to 1:30, it's the top 50 songs of 2022 part 1 of 2 on 91.5 The Beat in Kitchener, Ontario, Canada. It will be hard keeping track of both radio stations' countdowns. I never done this in my life before. Usually 91.5 The Beat countdown songs of the year is on Sunday, not Saturdays, and then on Saturday, December 31st from 5 to 7 p.m. is the top 50 songs of 2022 part 2 of 2.
I have a major in my life, but